In this view, we will be demonstrating an AP axial view of the cervical spine. The AP axial cervical spine should be performed with the patient standing at the upright bucky or lying on the table, with a 40-inch source-to-image distance and a 15 to 20 degree cephalic tube angulation. We are going to add a 15 cephalic angle. We're going to center at C4 in the mid-sagittal plane. We're going to leave the collimation open lengthwise. Collimate from side to side with a right marker over here. We're centered to the IR. We have a 15 degree cephalic angle centered at C4. Just relax your hands for me. And the patient will hold very still. A diagnostic AP axial cervical spine radiograph must be free of motion and rotation. Demonstrated anatomy to include bony detail of the cervical spine. The intervertebral disc spaces should be open with the spinous processes equal distance to the pedicles and aligned with the midline of the cervical bodies. In this view, we will be demonstrating the AP open mouth cervical spine. The AP open mouth cervical spine should be performed with the patient standing at the upright bucky or lying on the table. A 30 to 40 inch source to image distance is recommended with no tube angulation. This view is a view of the dens or the odontoid in the open mouth. If you do not open the mouth, then the teeth or the base of the skull is in the way. Right now, I have my central ray at the closed lips. The central ray is actually at the open mouth, but it's an uncomfortable position for the patient to hold, so I'm going to do that last. I have everything centered, all the locks are engaged. My SID is between 30 and 40 inches. I'm going to stand here to the side of her. This is the best position for the technologist to stand. The central ray here, when she opens her mouth, it is the incisor tooth to the mastoid, and that plane must run perpendicular to the IR. And the best way to be able to adjust her head to ensure that that's perpendicular is to the side of her. So I'm going to have you open your mouth really wide, and I'm going to adjust her chin forward or back to make sure that the incisor to the mastoid is running perpendicular. As I step away from the patient, I'm going to instruct the patient to say "ah," and that depresses the tongue in the floor of the mouth, and then the exposure is taken. A diagnostic AP open mouth cervical spine radiograph must be free of motion and rotation. Demonstrated anatomy to include the dens, atlas, axis, and articulations between the first and second cervical vertebrae with proper visualization of soft tissue and bony detail. In this view, we will be demonstrating an AP axial cervical spine left posterior oblique, an LPO. The AP axial oblique cervical spine, LPO, view should be performed with the patient standing at the upright bucky or lying on the table. A 72-inch source to image distance and a 15 to 20 degree cephalic tube angulation. The next two views are the obliques. I'm going to choose to do posterior obliques because it puts the spine closer to the IR. They actually can be done anterior obliques. I'm going to keep the original 15 degree cephalic angle that I used. If you turn the patient around and do an anterior oblique, it would be a 15 degree caudate angle. When we turn the patient 45 degrees, I'm going to turn the patient to her left-hand side here. And when we do this, we have a little bit of object image distance. To compensate for that, or that possible magnification, I'm going to increase my SID to 72 inches. Again, I'm going to keep the angle, which was 15 degrees cephalic. We're still going to center in the same location, which was C4. patient is LPO, so I'm going to use a left marker indicating the left side of the body. So again, I have 15 degrees cephalic angle, centered at C4. I'm at 72 SID. This is an LPO. It will actually show the right intervertebral foramina. The patient is shielded. The patient will hold very still, and the exposure is made. A diagnostic AP axial cervical spine, left posterior oblique, LPO, radiograph must be free of motion with a 45 degree rotation. Demonstrated anatomy to include 7 cervical and the first thoracic vertebrae. The open intervertebral foramina furthest from the image receptor with proper visualization of soft tissue and bony detail. In this view, we will be demonstrating the AP axial cervical spine right posterior oblique RPO. The AP axial oblique cervical spine right posterior oblique RPO view should be performed with the patient standing at the upright bucky or lying on the table. A 72-inch source to image distance and a 15 to 20 degree cephalic tube angulation. Now we're going to do the opposing oblique. So I'm going to turn the patient to the right. This will be an RPO. So I'm going to turn her 45 degrees. I'm going to remove my left marker and place a right marker on the right side of her. We still have 72 SID. We still have a 15 degree cephalic angle. We're still going to be centered at C4. I'm going to step you forward just a little bit. Patient's going to hold very still, and the exposure's made. A diagnostic AP axial cervical spine, right posterior oblique, RPO view. Radiograph must be free of motion and have a 45 degree rotation. Demonstrated anatomy to include 7 cervical vertebrae and the first thoracic vertebrae, the open intervertebral foramina furthest from the image receptor with proper visualization of soft tissue and bony detail. In this view, we will be demonstrating the lateral cervical spine. The lateral cervical spine should be performed with the patient standing or seated at the upright bucky or lying on the table with a 72-inch source to image distance and with no tube angulation. The last view we will do will be a lateral. You can actually do a right or a left, it does not matter. So we're going to turn her to her right side facing the board. She is completely turned sideways, so I've got a right marker indicating the right side, and it is anterior. We're going to take the angle off the machine. This will be done perpendicular, and we will keep the 72 SID, and the central ray still is at C4. I'm going to sit you forward a little bit. It's a really good idea to have this patient depress their shoulders so we can get C7 here. And we are centered again on the coronal plane and C4. We've got the right marker in the front. And again, 72-inch distance with a perpendicular central ray. Patient holds very still and the exposure is made. A diagnostic lateral cervical spine must be free of motion and rotation. Demonstrated anatomy to include 7 cervical vertebrae and the upper portion of T1, superimposed zygapophyseal joints and opened intervertebral disc bases, spinous processes in profile with proper visualization of soft tissue and bony detail.
If you enjoyed this video, I encourage you to visit cloverlearning.com and explore our robust selection of video-based courses, certification exam prep question banks, and continuing education resources. Lastly, please remember to hit the like button, subscribe, and turn on notifications so you can stay up to date on our latest videos.